So this is one of the salvo stores that I go to, but they don't normally have a lot of stuff, so we'll have a look around. And I've also changed my backpack today, so hopefully I don't have a lot of rubbing like my other videos that I've had on the GoPro. No real board games or toys or anything like that here. It's on the outside. I don't know if I've got that game. One's got a, Wii Player's got a scratch on it, pretty bad one. Okay, three games. Actually got a couple of Blu-rays there as well. Spider-Man, I just can't remember if I've got them or not in a set. $2 each is pretty good. And Avatar, but I think I might already have that one. And Cars, Up, Monsters, Inc. Some DVDs, but nothing really that I'm after. This store does tend to have some CDs from time to time. It's a random DS game. Grab that. Right, well, I'm not going to look at homewares, otherwise my husband's going to kill me. Panasonic TV, $80. Don't need it. I'm pretty happy with that, so I'm gonna get these games and then head to the next salvo store. All right, so FIFA 06, GameCube. I generally check the discs. Just because. But yeah, they've really discounted everything here at the moment, which is great. Yeah, it's pretty wrecked. So even for a shelf filler, I wouldn't get that. But there's some DS games. Nothing I'm really after there. My friend Wayne keeps telling me to play Gears of War. I think I've got that game though, in a box set. Oh, they're all big packs. Probably not interested in that. But, Destiny and Watch Dogs for $5. Battlefield 4, $10. Xbox One. It's pretty cheap on some of those games. Alright. So yeah, this is one of my stores that I come to a fair bit. I just find that they seem to have some good bargains occasionally, and especially like they've been discounting all their games a lot. I'm not in the market for any PS4 games at the moment, just simply because I've got a big backlog, so I'm not going to look at them. But $30. So here's a selection of their games. Now, they were 2-for-1, but they must have just pulled out the ones that they wanted to really discount off, which were at the front, which I was just going through before. So it's a bit disappointing because I was hoping to come here today and be able to get 2-for-1 games. So it makes them, you know, like $3 each, but not to be. They've got some pretty good Xbox games there. They've got Tomb Raider, more Gears of War, Rambo game, and PS2. Nothing I'm really looking for, but gives you an idea of what we've got here in Australia. Oh my god, whoops. I have not seen that before. Jackass the game. I think I'll get that one. I don't know if it's probably overpaying for it, but and I might see if they'll do me a deal on some of the games anyway. Oh, it's pretty wrecked. No, I'm not going to get it, but I'm going to remember that because that'd be so much fun. Some PSP games, a couple of UMD or one UMD. It's a little bit disappointing. There's not much here. Nothing on Wii that I'm after. A Scooby-Doo, but it's $25. Doing that. Thank you. Heaps of DVDs. But they do have a section here with some games in it. Generally, they have some retro down the bottom, but nothing's really changed in here since I was had been in a couple of months ago. So yeah, a little bit of a bust today, but that's all right. $25 for an N64 controller. They've got almost thought that was the anniversary PS4 just from the color of it, but it's not. It's just the lights hitting it up the top there. DSi for $35 boxed. It's probably not a bad price for an Australian released one, but I'm not in the market for it. But anyway, that'll be it for today in Cashew, so we'll get somewhere else. Alright, so that was a bit of a bust at Cashew's, and I also had to ask permission before I started recording because they do know me there. So I thought it was the right thing to do. But now I'm at what's called a Lifeline, which is another op shop. This one has a lot of homewares and clothes and stuff like that in it. So I must admit, I probably only bought a few things here over the time. Like I got the cool 90s Nook desk from here, which was a bit of an effort because I had to pull it apart myself and try and lay it in pieces in the back of my Rex. But anyway, it was fun. And then I probably bought like bits of retro furniture for inside the house here and there. So that white thing's actually pretty good. That'd probably make a good thing in a games room because it's so slim. But yeah, so as for games and that though, they don't really have a lot or have had a lot over the years, like, and they write on their board games, which, you know, always makes me not buy them. So oh, that one's like stuck on with tape, but normally they just write on them with black pen. And yeah, like obviously when you collect board games you don't want big black text on the front of them. But yeah, there's not much here, just a few toys that look pretty ragged. Go and have a look in the DVD section. And CDs, see what's around. Cool little popcorn maker, 35. But our op shops are much different than the US when I've been looking at people doing their finds over there. Like they have so many more so much more in the electronic section and stuff like that as well. Like I'd love for us to have heaps of, you know, VHS and, you know, maybe even beta or laserdisc machines and stuff like that, but we just don't seem to have big op shops like that. There might be some sort of in South Brisbane closer to Ipswich area, but not many. So here's some PC games, which I'm never in the market for. God, got so much money on their Blu-rays. More PC. Nope. So this one's a bust as well, guys. Unfortunately, no books, no nothing. Yeah, it's a little disappointing, but I've still got a couple more to go and have a look at. So we'll get going and have a look for some more. Well, this is one of my favorite op shops. Found numerous things here, like cool old Where's Wally books. What else did I find here? Cassettes, CDs from the 90s, stuff like that. So unique. Pretty much tried. That's so funny. I'll get that. They're probably going to charge me $1 for that, so. But. course, that one's missing. Damn it. All right, well. It's probably not a little bad little haul. So I should get these for $2 each. And, yeah, pretty happy with that. Toy section over here. Have a quick look at that. Seem to be power shopping today. Always look in the toy section because I love Care Bears. So I look for any sort of vintage, like mid to late 80s Care Bears toys or My Little Pony. But to this day, I haven't found them. I've had to buy them off eBay, unfortunately. But yeah, so this is one of the bigger stores. And yeah, I'm pretty happy with these games that I've got, and I should get them for $2 each. All right, on to the next one. Now, I don't even try and park down in this Salvo's. I have to park all the way around in another fucking shopping center, sorry to swear. But because this is like super busy car park, and I think this is one of the busiest Salvo's I've been to. Now, at this particular one, the scores that I've got over the years would be I've bought so many dollar board games, and yeah, they're like excellent condition or complete. I've left a couple too, which I do really regret back in the day. But look at this retro thing. Oh my God, the moon stick. It's a newer one, but pogo stick's pretty funny. All right. Right, Warcraft game, Fallout game, all the PC looks like they've discounted it to a dollar. But as I said, I'm not a PC collector, just the retro games I really like that I played as a kid. Nothing there.
What, the T-Rex? Yeah. It has like an elastic on it, I know. So it was bound to happen.
Может быть много, Вадика много может быть, а если не хочешь такого, может быть.
What? Another bust for today at this store. I have to admit, I really haven't found any retro games here before or any video games in general. I've just found board games, which has been great, but let's go to the next one. All right, so here's the last one that I'll be going to today. There is one more, but I've only ever got an Alf plush toy from there, so. Can you see that? That was insanely priced. That was $50 for a Pokemon guide. Are you kidding me? I have no idea what to expect now. So So over the years, I have got a few bargains here. I got some Wii U games that they must have mispriced, and they were 50 cents, and they tried to correct it at the counter, but I said, no, you can't do that because that's not my fault that you priced it wrong. But I do. I buy other stuff here, like books and stuff like that. But they don't have anything today, and I'm actually a bit concerned if they did, considering they had $50 on that bloody book over there. Yeah, they have a box set TV series, which is pretty cool. CDs, but it doesn't look like there's any PS1 games hiding in there, which is why I go through the CDs all the time. Alright, so Buzz Lightyear, but I did get one of those in better condition for a bit cheaper from another op shop. But yeah, there's not much here really, unfortunately. And yeah, it's very, very overpriced, so I'll have to get into going to a few other ones in the coming. So I remember there's another little store around here and another one, so it's two more I'm gonna hit today. But this one's a Australian Red Cross. It's always pretty busy, but yeah, they'll probably look at me funny for talking to myself, but anyway. These are cute though. Not that I need them. Emirates bags. They're pretty cute. There's a blue and a red one down there. This is where I got one cool item in the games room, which was the Buzz Lightyear. But I don't think I've ever really seen any games here except for PC. Alright, it's probably going to be a quick look. No. Nothing at all. Alright. So, let's go have a look at the other one today. See, hopefully that there might be some VHS or something at this other one. So let's go. Unfortunately, this is going to be lucky last today, guys. There's not many more I'm able to get to, and not really having the best luck, so sort of think I'll try again going hunting on the weekend or something. Some other
Okay, bye bye.
Bye.
Absolutely nothing. Well, at least today I got some games. Well, that's a shame. EB Games have a pretty wicked sale. And since I had a bit of a bust at all my op shops, I thought, why not give it a try, check it out, see what I can find. If anything, I am on a spending ban from new games, but yeah, I wouldn't mind maybe getting some cheaper games. DualShock controllers are on sale as well. Switch games. Hopefully they've got the buy one. I think it's buy one, get two free or something for $18. Too free.
Yeah. Oh, okay, no, appreciate it.
That's pretty cool. Hell yes. I'm gonna get that one. So looking forward to going back and playing all them. Grid, maybe? Looks cool. Lost Planet 2. Got aside. This is one I wanted to get because I'm currently playing through Heavy Rain at the moment and I'm really enjoying it. So yeah, I'll definitely be grabbing that one. Some good games at store.
Two different TVs.
Yeah, okay.
And they're not working on it.
Okay, yeah, those sound like some cables.
Too many to actually go through now, the two. So definitely gonna get that. And the God of War.
And do you normally get your food on the scrap warranty?
Just not sure on these two.
Yeah.
Might get Lost Planet 2 because it's a Capcom game. Alright, sorry about that. Bags getting tangled up. Said no PS4 games.
Yeah, they released it for like a month and then they just.
But I will have a little look.
Because they figured out that they were making money through buying.
Yeah.
They make it free, but then, you know, eventually they're spending money. So the Battle Pass is just 2 PM.
Just because there's such a good sale. Breaking the store. People keep raving about this game. Never played it. Thank you. heaps of pre-owned games. And I'm really making a mess of the store. They're gonna think I'm deliberately breaking it. I hope you're all having a laugh at me at this moment. Because they're gonna slip off. Alright. Witcher. I've seen a lot of people playing that lately, and it's one I probably will get at a later stage. But yeah, there's probably no other ones that I want to get at the moment. But I do want to get these ones, so. Arrangement of Xboxes as well for you Xbox lovers. Oh my gosh, look how cute that backpack is. I'm not allowed any more loot from Zelda though. Alright, well, I'm going to get these three PS3 games, and yeah, definitely looking forward to Beyond Two Souls once I finish.